Hello, welcome back. As you can see, the lasers are aligned, the black hole is aligned, and this is a beautiful scene. Kind of spooky, actually. And as you can see, the energy is aligned to exactly open the door. So this is how you open the door in the embassy. You just have to wait until, you know... Ooh, it's dark in here. Just have to wait until it's aligned. Yes, and how do you proceed then? Okay, let's do a little bit of a jumping. I mean, this was not a hard fight, but I was not ready for a fight. I was actually expecting no one to be here. Okay, so like I said, if the energy is aligned, you can open this one over here and also the one in Port Isodun. So this is the one in outer space, so I'm wearing the repaired Eva suit, as you can see. That means I can breathe in outer space. So let's see what the big deal was about. Oh, the White Hand Prophet. Actually, that's a big deal. Because this is actually a great weapon, as you can see it deals energy damage and it... Let's actually test it out. Huh. It's almost like a shotgun blast now, but the more you level it up, the better it will become, and I love it actually. Because it makes you even more deadly and the enemy won't know what you have. So you have a lot of spells that are actually called hand. So I think there are 3 or 4 more hands to get, and they deal different damage types and have different skills and so on, but this is one of the cooler things. I mean, look at your hand, it's a claw, it's a white claw. Anyway, that was a funny little thing to do, so let's get back to the serious business. As you can see, the door stays open for the whole duration while this is aligned. So as you can see, it's on the top right hand. And you just have to come here. So spooky. So yeah, the station is actually powered by the dark energy. Okay, I almost fell down. It's powered by the dark energy of the black hole. So the black hole is actually a power source, remember that. It will be useful for later. Because this was the main purpose of the station. I have some actions over there. Well, if you're interested how you make the jump, well... the jump is kind of hard to make, so let me show you again. I actually took the higher road, because the first time I played it, I failed a lot of times. And yeah, the jumping in the game still needs a lot of work, in my opinion. And I think it will receive a lot of work over time, but for now, it's a little wonky. So I'll just show you the whole path, and then you can decide if that loot is worth it. But again, you just have to level everything up in the game, because if you want to do some PvP, well, you'll have more fun if you unlock everything. And besides, some people are just crazy collectors. They want to collect all the secrets, all the items, all the stuff. So right now we're in the embassy. You know, that bridge that you get when you defeat the first boss. So let's jump down over here. Oh, won't be fighting anyone. We'll just go up there. The funny thing about that secret is that there are a lot of doors in the game that actually need you to wait. They only need you to wait. That's the only condition. And if you want to know how you craft the fixed Eva suit, you just have to watch my other video. It's basically a recipe you find in the Underside Arcology, or the Arcology Underside. So this is a wall you can open. As you can see, people have put their grubby little hands all over it. What is my ghost doing here? And you can just fall down or climb down the stairs now. And remember, you have to interact with this thing over here. Because this is the depressurization before you go into space. Open. This is space. If you don't have the suit, well, you'll basically freeze and die in a few... in about a minute. So you can just go up here to see what's here and then go back. Easy now, easy. And as you can see, I have retrieved my action. So there is a little platform over there. You just jump to this one and then you jump to that one over there. Don't jump on the pillar, it's so dangerous. Jump on that platform, pillar, then the stairs, and then you just go up the stairs and then you reach that room. Easy as pie, okay. Now let's actually go for another secret that was kind of important. Remember, you can teleport back. Oh, we look so bad. I mean, so cool. And you saw on the right side of the screen where the projection actually hits the room. So you just have to follow that line. You know, follow that line, the dotted line. Actually, it's a full line. Okay, so let me show you another secret. I hope I find it very, very fast. There is, again, it's a lot of walking, but it was related to space, so I thought I should show it right now. Because I didn't show it in my other video. So the archaeology understudy, as you can see, the SAS, which is basically like the airlock, safety air, might be something related to that, might be the acronym for that. And it's the same protocol. Ooh. I actually did a lot of this video, I mean the whole pathing and all the other stuff on another video. So, some stuff might not be active or some stuff might need you to, you know, take it down. Also, I fought a boss in that area. The transporter. So, instead of going that way, we'll have to go this way because this is kind of like the shortcut I unlocked. Or we might just die and, you know, fall to our death and die. Oh, look, we missed the pit. We missed the pit. That's hilarious. Yeah, I really wish they would do something about the jumping. I mean, yeah, I could wear lighter armor, but still, sometimes it doesn't help. Well, and if I fail too many times, I'll just have to take the safe route, which is kind of boring anyway. Anyway, so this is one of the main reasons you need to... Wait, no, not there. You need to increase your load, because if you're not able to jump over high distance... Oh, how hard are you doing that? By the way, this is actually one of the best ways to defeat your ghost. Just wear very bad gear. Gear that is not leveled up. Gear that is not unlocked its mastery. And your ghost will be extremely easy to defeat. Now, as you can see, my total load is 44 out of 75, so if you have 75 or more, you can basically make all the jumps and do all the combat. If not, well, there is no other way to get that loot, so... Yeah, load is not, you know, an optional stat. You have to invest a lot of stats into it. No, don't visit the last bridge. I just need a little light. Okay, so let me see, where are we and where are we going? Now, this was the place for a secret, so this is definitely not the place. Sorry, because of the game looking so similar all over the place, sometimes you'll have a very hard time remembering where stuff is. Okay, so we're going over here, and I'll actually have to go back to that other bus. So we can't really go back there. That's a shame. That's a real, real shame. Guess it is the long road. Okay, and now we actually have to go down a level. I mean, you can go, but there is nothing. The game kind of tricks you into believing, you know, it's safe and you have to go this way, but don't. So, probably the best advice I can give you in this area is just don't trust everything you see. Yeah, but I thought you could go back there, but apparently the developers don't want you to have it easy. Now, I already did all the secrets in the area, so it's kind of pointless to repeat them. So I'll just go to the main thing. Now, this is kind of like a not such hard jump. Okay, that's the airlock over there, in case you need. By the way, this is a glass window. Don't be alarmed, you will not fall into space. Okay, the fights here are optional, but again, you really want to finish them, otherwise they'll just be a pain for you when you're doing your jumping. Trust me, don't want to get hit by the flamethrower. Okay, relax man, relax, chill. So yeah, you can even kill these guys without having too much gear. Peekaboo, I see you. Okay, we have to go up here. We don't talk about things like that. We just don't talk about things like that. Yes, the beautiful. So, the key to, you know, attach to the ladder appeared for about, let's say, 0.01 seconds for me. And that will sometimes happen. So, your best chance is to just, you know, open a bridge on the other side and keep it there. No, okay, this will be kind of a longer video. I don't want it to be longer, but again, it's going to take a lot of tries. And I really don't like this. And my cubes doesn't shoot anymore because of bugs, okay. Okay, keep calm, everything is under control. This is one of the reasons that people don't really like the game or play it. It has some weird bugs in it. Kind of forces you to reset your progression if you don't make the right move or if you have a little bad luck like I had over there. I was really under the impression you could go to that other side because that's your final destination, but no, 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 no. You have to do it the hard way. Okay, doesn't really matter. We can speed things up now. Anyway, the more you do it, the faster you will do it next time, right? So that's the plus side. By the way, there shouldn't be any ice over here, but I guess people are getting... are slacking off, and by people I mean demons or... Stop shooting, I was not even shooting. Okay, this time we can do it. Funny thing, I actually did this on my first attempt the first time, but... what's wrong with the game today? It didn't even show me the prompt to actually grab the ladder this time. Oh, yeah. I mean, I practiced the jumps and all of those things before I started the video, but apparently... now it doesn't really want to cooperate at all, so I'm forced to do the same level over and over because of a silly jump. Okay. Man, sometimes the game is not really... it's not really what you expect it to be. Did I tell you I don't care about you? No, we don't care about him at all, so let's try that again. Sorry about that, but there's nothing I can do about it if I don't see the prompt for the jump. I mean, I'm making harder jumps over here than that, but apparently that one is evading me. Anyway, this is one of those areas that you have to take really, really slow. And sometimes you don't have enough speed, and I don't understand this, but hey. You just don't have enough momentum. Sometimes even the computer or the AI thinks, well, he's a very unlucky guy. Let me help him out a little bit. And this is the equivalent of mind games. Kind of like this, okay, a little lower. Okay, we made it. The holy grail of platforming. By the way, it would be so useful if you had that other thing that actually allows you to see the hidden platforms over here, but I don't have it, so eh. Okay, let's activate this bridge. Now there is another guy who is very, very angry in this building. Okay, calm down, I'm not going to hurt you. Oh, we're actually in the same building, what did I do? Something went horribly wrong. Okay, so this is the same building. What am I doing? I don't know. Let's go over here. Use the ladder. Go up here. And you get to the same place. Well, actually, I'm showing you all the stuff and all the secrets. Anyway, this is our final destination. Well, not final, I hope we'll survive through it. But we kind of had to go there anyway to activate the bridge, so it's all okay. And through here you just go up like the other one. Say hello to this guy. They very rarely go for that heavy attack, but apparently this guy was very, very angry right now. So let me see, our next objective will be to find another platform, because if you go after here, on this side you'll actually go to the crowbar. That's the same side, okay. I really recommend you kill all of them, otherwise there'll be a big problem because they'll start to shoot you and they'll also wake up their friends. So that's basically the beginning of the platform. And this is a completely new platform. Easy now, easy, don't fall down. Okay, we'll have to kill him because he's not going to let us do what we have to do here. Well, the timing was not perfect, but it was pretty decent. Okay, so this is kind of like the highest point. Let me see if I can see that platform from over here. Again, you kind of need to see the platforms with the hidden cube over here, but apparently that's not going to work. So let me check that again. Why is not showing me? Okay, I understand right now. Let's actually be a little more careful now. Yeah, he kind of shoots at you from that range. Very annoying. I hope they fix that sometimes. That guy has the range of, I don't know, 1000. Anyway, he's kind of overpowered, so let's just do our thing. So this is the crowbar location, or the pry bar as it's called. And we have to go inside here and, you know, where the big guy is. And we have to have a talk with him. Okay, he decided to give up. That was a wise decision from his part. Actually, let me check this one more time because I want to be sure it's the right way. Because this is an empty room and I never understood why it was empty. Well, probably just to impress us or something. Okay, let's go up here. Careful now. And this is the room where you have to go to the bottom of the pit. Now, I think there are some missing platforms over here, but let's just do our best. Okay, easy now. This is also where you find the nervous wiring. So that's why I'm scanning a little bit for it. Careful now. We can just walk on this side. Why is that empty? Why is there nothing there? It scares me when something is empty like that. Okay, we can walk on that. I think we have to jump this. Well, it could be the end of me. Okay, that was another perfect jump, thank you. So the nervous wiring should be somewhere around here along with the armature set. Probably the set is at the end. Oh, I wish we had a bridge over here. What? It's not the nervous wiring, then where is it? Probably further down the line. Again, sorry about the longer video, but it takes so much time to clear the pathway and to remember the road. And this game will destroy, absolutely destroy your nerves. whatever. Even if I miss the nervous wiring or anything else, we'll just have to reach the bottom of the pit. Okay, I'm starting to tremble right now. Man, who came up with this crazy design for this thing? Okay, he should no longer be called a gaming developer. I guess we have to jump on the pillar, but I'm afraid to jump on the pillar, so I'll just jump on the ground. Still, I don't see anything resembling loot over here. My hands are so sweaty at this point. Okay, so finally we have the nervous wiring, which is kind of like what you need to finish the game and get the full story or the true ending. Okay, apparently I have to go even deeper into the bottomless pit. Of space. Some people are just maniacs. Why did they do it like this? So this is the way back. Okay, I don't want to go back. I want to go even further down the rabbit hole. So can I go on this path to go lower, or is this the final one? Again, there are not a lot of guides on the internet about this. They just show you some pictures and it's basically good luck with that. Okay, let's try the other side, just in case. Oh, look, a lucky coin. Well, thank you for the lucky coin, but that's not really what I wanted. Anyway, the nervous wiring is over here, in case you are wondering, and that's one of the items most people don't find. Okay, I guess we have to go up with the lift, because there is no other alternative. That camera angle will scare me sometimes. I thought it was something special, but no. We have to go up with the elevator and then probably do some crazy stunts again. Now, the problem is I don't know where I am, so I guess if I go that way, there is an elevator, and that might mean I will go to safety. I don't want to go to safety. I want to go. Okay, and this is again the same problem. I don't know what's the right path. Okay, I see the dead robot over there, so that's not the right path. Why, developers? Why? Why? this is a stupid leap of faith. Well, thank you very much. That was a very silly thing. So I did most of the puzzles, but this was just the most ridiculous one you'll ever see. Sorry about the longer video, but again, practicing this and actually performing it is a totally different thing. So where is that armature thing? I mean, it's not better, but it looks cooler. Oh, look at that. It's actually an armored suit. Well, more or less armored. So now you actually look like a proper space marine. I guess this is the space marine or the military variant of the Eva suit. Also, let's look at the Nervous Warren, because that's one of the things that people really wish they had. Nervous wiring. And again, this is just, you need this to actually get the true ending of the game, or the, to say it properly, the complete true ending of the game. So let's see the stats of this thing. So physical is 59, 47, 20, okay. So 20 nihil, 79, 47. Let's compare it to the other one. So 59 again. I'm a bit nervous because of all the things I had to do. I never thought a game would make my hands shake like this or sweat like this ever since I played Escape from Tarkov. This is one step ahead of that game. So this is the normal suit, 57, 45. Okay, so it's worse against knee heal, it's worse against induction. It's better against induction, so the only thing it's, don't use it against knee heal. And I guess for that extra two physical, whichever might be. Which is probably only for the from the helmet and from the rig. Well, I guess you can mismatch it a little bit. Ah, but I'll just wear the full set because I like it and because this was one of the hardest things to do. Especially do it on camera and didn't practice before. So now space is no longer the final frontier, we have conquered space even. And this leads us where? Okay, I'll just go to a bridge where I'm safe and then I'll end the video because... Man, this was a hard task. What were those maniacs thinking? Okay, that was funny. Anyway, see you next time. I hope you also get the Aegis armature. Bye!